So Wes, how's your can going so far?
Well, it's great. I love it. I've never been here before, you know, it's quite a bit. I'm learning the rituals, it's you feel like you want to be a part of it.
And it's a big deal to have your film be the opening night entertainment. Did you watch it with a crowd, and how did it go down?
Yes, I did watch it with a crowd. It's hard for me to really experience it like a movie. I really am just sort of I'm like a part of the editorial department doing a technical check when I watch the movie. That's really all I see, various flaws. But it was great. I mean, it's a huge room. I don't think I've ever shown a movie in a room that size before. Very exciting.
It was really fun to be here last night. You know, we had the premiere, and it was so overwhelming. I've never really seen anything quite so large. It just felt crazy. But I was next to Bruce Willis, and you know, I get why Bruce Willis is the man in a good way. Like, you're next to him, and there is a feeling of, Bruce will get you through this. Everything's gonna be okay. You know, I'm looking around at all these flashing lights and all these people, and I look at Bruce, and he's just like, and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna stay with him. So I see why he is such a big action star.
And you said before that Moonrise Kingdom is based partly on your own experiences growing up in Texas. Can you tell us to what extent that's true?
Well, that's not really true. I said that.
Oh, I may have.
I probably may. Yeah.
Well, I think we talked last time about the scout the scout troop had been.
Yes. I tried to be a scout, but I didn't really succeed. I never distinguished myself as a scout. I never had an experience like an island like this or that sort of summer colony sort of thing, but I did have the experience of falling in love at 12 years old with someone, and that feeling has stuck with me and is a very strong memory for me. And the movie sort of I think it's something like the fantasy I had at that time, the story I invented at that time, a sort of adventure. So I feel like it's in a way there's an autobiographical thing.
Now, to change the subject onto your moustache, in the movie you have
that's my helicopter.
You have
Can you wrap
me,
it up?
Well, huh?
That's my helicopter. Can
oh,
you
that's
wrap
yours?
It up? Yeah.
I thought it was mine.
Sorry.
You're rocking a very luxuriant moustache in Moonrise Kingdom.
Yeah.
Was that Wes's idea, or did you bring the moustache to the table?
That was Wes's idea. It's very thin, that moustache.
Mm.
And, it is luxurious. Yeah, it's sort of like my... it's not quite a David Niven. Because I feel like David Niven, he's sort of floated in the... in the English Channel, between the nose and the upper lip, whereas mine, I think, was more of like a beach on my upper lip.
Right.
You know, but it's very hard. These people, you know, I have facial hair, but I usually, it'll just sort of come in, you know. But when I see someone with a very, like, intricate, that is a very complicated thing to do.
Mm.
It takes all kinds of tools.
I wanted to ask you quickly about the soundtrack to Moonrise Kingdom. You know, obviously it's a period movie. Did that restrict you, or was that?
No, it was that in a way part the music was part of what led me to make it a period film. I think I had this idea of Benjamin Britten being sort of the setting for the movie. And you know, Britten's a little, you know, these are Britten pieces. I think Noah's Flood is from 55 or 58 or something, it gave us a musical flavor to work with. I think the period.
Now, as a final question, what have you got coming up?
I have something that I'm working on, but I can't talk about it because it might not happen, and then I'll be really embarrassed.
Can you mime?
Oh,
okay. All right. Whatever that is, I'm looking forward to seeing it.
Thank you.